السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today إن شاء الله we're going to share with you a lesson from Divine Revelation which is سورة النزاعات from verses 1 to verse 26. To make the things easy for you, if you go to the, through the verses from 1 to 5, we find out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks or swear by the angel and the, same time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the duty of each of them. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created angels to be in the service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the verse number 1, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالنَّازِعَاتِ غَرْقَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear by the angel, وَالنَّازِعَاتِ غَرْقَى, which means the angel that takes the soul out of the body of the disbeliever with violence. Why? Because they used to do bad in their life. Allah, when they will pass away, they will suffer. While Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide an angel to take the soul out of the body of the believer with soft, gently, so they will not suffer because they used to do good in their life, by saying one nashitati nashta. So as we said, from verse number 5 to number 1 to verse number 5, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear by the angel and at the same time show us the duty of each of them. I request you to go through the verses and you need to know the duty of each of them. From the verse number 6 to verse number 14, we find out that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the sum of the signs of the Day of Judgment. When he said, يَوْمَ تَرْجُفُ الرَّاجِفَةَ تَتْبَعُهَا الرَّادِفَةَ. The scholars say that means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will order angel Israfil to blow the trumpet for the first time to make all the creatures die, all the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the earth, by this trumpet, they will die. تَتْبَعُهَا الرَّادِفَةَ. It will be followed by another trumpet to make them raise up again and stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, waiting for judgment. From verse number 14 to verse number 6, we find out that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking or speaking about the story of Prophet Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun. And I think all of you knows, or most of you knows, the story of Musa and Fir'aun by saying, هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَى إِذْ نَادَاهُ رَبُّهُ بِالْوَادِ الْمُقَدَّسِ طُوًى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed Prophet Musa alayhi salam by saying to him, you need to go to Fir'aun and you need to speak with him with kindness and soft to believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know that Fir'aun, he was an arrogant king, the king of Egypt. Okay, he was an arrogant king, and he exceeded the limits of disbelief, and he called the people to worship him. So Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Prophet Musa alayhi salam to Fir'aun, but Fir'aun he rejected the message of Musa. What was the punishment of Fir'aun? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala drawing him in the worldly life to make him a lesson for the people. So here we can find out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks or info or swear by the angels, and he talks also about the signs of the Day of Judgment, and he talks about the consequences of the wrongdoer by through this the story of Fir'aun and Prophet Musa alayhi salam. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention all of this? mention all of this to confirm the people about the truth of the day of judgment, and also to confirm about the people about the consequences of the wrongdoing. So we as a Muslim, we should take a lesson of that. When we know the consequences of the wrongdoer, like Fir'aun, and we know the jobs of the angels, and we know there will be a day for the people to be judged. So we should prepare ourselves for that day. We should take a lesson, and we should do good in our life by doing all the good deeds, by observing all the acts of worship, honoring parents, believing in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? To prepare ourselves for that day. That's all, my dear. I hope you be eager to do good in your life. And we as a Muslim, we believe in the Day of Judgment as one of the six pillars of Iman. Assalamu alaikum.